So this is Home Run Quizzes, and I am Jai Rana, helping Rushabh Gudade's initiative of COVID-21, which is an online quiz series that Rushabh does as a part of Home Run Quizzes, and it is going on since the lockdown has started, and it will go on till the lockdown will end as promised. So we do this every day. Rushabh does this every day, and it is a 15 question quiz where you have to WhatsApp or text your answers on Facebook or Instagram. Do not comment your answers. Do not comment your answers. And if we are ready, we'll begin. But before that, let us discuss the answers of yesterday. Yesterday's first question. So we had 6 questions on books, and the quiz was set by Vrishabh. First question was about a book being made into an Academy Award film. This was Forrest Gump. Forrest Gump. Question two was about different actors portraying the same character, the character being Sherlock Holmes. Question three, all hell breaks loose. Identify the book. So the book was Inferno. Inferno by Dan Brown. And question four was about simply 1984. The eye you could see was a very helpful hint for you all. Question number five was about a phrase which had several numbers rejected, eventually having the title Catch 22. So this is Catch 22. I'll go a bit slow because we promised to start at 8, so few people might be joining. I'll discuss all the answers at the end. Question number six, the last question on the theme of books. This was about a person's interest into secret and puzzles. So it was an interesting question on Dan Brown himself. So this is how Dan Brown got involved into the genre of books that he is famous for. Dan Brown being the answer. Then we had 5 questions on words and phrases. So the first question was about a certain phrase that came from ship transportation and initiating something. So a gesture showed affiliation and understanding between two territories was a hint. This was breaking the ice. Breaking the ice was the phrase. Question number eight was about a common, very much heard word these days, getting its origins from old French, from the words cover and fire. So French words for to cover and fire were curfew, giving the word curfew. Question number eight was about curfew. Question number nine. Question number nine was as simple as how's that? So how's the batsman was shortened to how's that, an appeal that bowlers do while they are appealing for the wicket. Question number 10. So love, or also known as love all. This is the 0-0 score found in racket games of tennis and badminton. So tennis and badminton had and still has 0-0 score called as love or love all. Question number 11, a very popular old question about debatable question about the origins of the word quiz. So this is one of the supposed origin story which has been circulating since years. So origin of the word quiz actually find in Dublin Theatre with Richard Daly being the person. Question number 11 was as simple as quiz. Question number 12 was about a formula based question wherein you had to identify the logos and then go on to crack the eventual answer. So the first one was Wipro, new logo after the sunflower, and then we had Dabur, and the last one was as simple as Omega. So Wipro gives you an I, Dabur gives you an B, Dabur gives you a B, and Omega gives you M. So this is IBM. IBM, as simple as IBM. The singer was from New Zealand. This is the New Zealand singer Lorde. The voice that you had to identify. The statue in Bologna giving the logo of Maserati. Maserati, the trident that you see along the statue that gives the logo of Maserati, and a common theme that connects these are advanced publications. Advanced publications having interest in Condé Nast, Discovery, Reddit, and Wired. So advanced publications was the common theme across this. I will stay on the answers page for you all to take a note probably, or just go through. First was Forrest Gump, the novel that was made into a Academy Award winning film, Forrest Gump. Second was characters who portrayed Sherlock Holmes. Third was about Inferno and the book cover. Fourth was 1984 and the television with an I. Fifth was about how Catch 22 got its title after rejecting several numbers. Sixth was how Dan Brown popularly chose the genre and why Dan Brown is known for the genre that he's writing into. Seventh was about the phrase "break the ice" from the ship movements of earlier days. Eighth was how old French words gave the word curfew. Ninth was about the appeal "how's that." 10th was "love all" or "love love" giving the score 0-0. 11th was about the origins of the word quiz. 12th was IBM, the formula question. 13th was identifying the voice of Lorde. 14th was about the statue in Bologna giving the Maserati logo, and 15th being advanced publications, a common theme for Discovery, Reddit, Condé Nast, and Wired magazine. So this was the set by Vrushab, and today I am Jai Rana doing a mix set of 15 questions. The questions are simple. If you have attended my quizzes before, probably the answer is right there on the screen. I would give enough hints for you to crack the answers. I would repeat again, do not write anything in the comments section. Do not write anything in the comments section. Please send us your answers on WhatsApp if you are using it on a phone. If you're using it on a phone, please write down your answers on a piece of paper and send a photo of that answer. So we are accepting answers till 15 minutes past the quiz ends, probably till 8:45, and do not comment the answers. Let's begin with the first question. You can raise your queries and suggestions in the comment section. I would resolve them. Question number one. So let's begin. Question number one was about a particular telephone that is found in a certain museum in Stockholm. Okay, so it's an old red colored active phone, and it is not registered in the state directory, but only 4 people can call on this particular telephone. So only 4 people have the number of this particular telephone, and it is located in Stockholm. So who are these four people, or what are they collectively known as, is what I'm looking for. A museum dedicated to somebody. Okay, looking for four names, or either how they are collectively known as, who have the number of this particular phone that is situated in a museum in Stockholm. Okay, so question number two is about an art form where tarpa, a trumpet like instrument, is a common theme. So you commonly find tarpa in the center of this particular art form. In the art form, there are different village men entwine their hand and they move in a circle. So which art form is this that has village men with their hands entwined and moving in a circle, and a tarpa, which is a trumpet like instrument, in the center? I'm looking for a short word, a form of art. Question number three, simply, after which location in London are these large broad collars of cutwork lace that became fashionable in the 17th century named? Looking for one particular location in London. The location is known for its entertainment activities. The location is popularly known for its entertainment activities. Question 4. Back in time, when Kanji Manshu Desai agreed to join two Indian farm workers to take over the business of a Japanese American property owner, when the Japanese American property owner had to serve in the World War II, a certain form of business started in USA. So this is the origins of what business that has been associated with a particular community, which was started by Kanji Desai. So interestingly, now it is not known after Kanji Desai, but a different community, a particular business that is very much popular in USA, done by this particular community. So more than half of the people running this business are from this community. So which business and what community, both in some manner are rhyming. Question 5, what slangish name is given to these alcohol glasses, small sized alcohol glasses that feature six different criminals? Okay, I have a larger image for those who are looking on the phone. So they are alcohol glasses, think small sized alcohol glasses, and think what are pictures of criminals called, and you will arrive at the answer. What is a slangish name for these particular set of glasses? So, in which journalist, columnist, and author's honor were the JK Awards started in 2019 that provides grants up to $5,000 to five investigating journalists? Okay, so JK Awards are given in honor of which particular journalist or columnist, also an author? The awards started in 2019, last year. Question 7. What regretful activity does the app DD No prevent by hiding selected contact numbers from the phone for up to 48 hours? So you can tweak up the settings and change the duration for hiding the contact, but the particular alliterative activity, a regretful activity, is what I'm looking for. I have blanked the initial part. It says block mistakes, no more worrying, and it is developed by Explore Fun Inc. Simply looking for what regretful activity does the app DD No prevent. Question 8. What three-word title, a past tense of the original, was given to this ice cream flavor launched by Netflix in partnership with Ben and Jerry's? So there is a particular three-word phrase that is associated with Netflix, and this being an ice cream, a past tense was used. So what three-word title is this? That is a past tense of the original. Question 9. In the 1400s, prospecting chewing as one of the reasons for this unwanted occurrence. What were the women in the court of Louis the 11th trying to avoid by consuming only soup? So, the women in the court of Louis the 11th consumed only soup. So, there was a misconception or a myth that chewing would lead to something. And the something was an unwanted occurrence that women did not want. So, what is this unwanted occurrence that I'm looking for? For which chewing was considered as one of the reasons. Looking for one keyword, an unwanted occurrence. Question 10. What sound is quite aptly used to switch between the past reference scenes and the present in the police procedural comedy series Brooklyn Nine-Nine? So, even if you have not seen the show, this sound is commonly associated with one of the equipments that policemen carry, and it's a very short sound that is used in the show. The original sound is also somewhere associated with switching. So, what sound is used to switch between the scenes of Brooklyn Nine-Nine when they are referencing a past scene and then they come back to the present to use a switch sound what sound is being used. That is taken from one of the equipments that policemen usually carry. That being question number 10. Question number 11 is, what nickname is given to such progress bars that share their design with an object that was used to denote two professions in the older days? So ideally the object is named after one particular profession, but the same profession did two jobs. So this is like policemen doing policeman work and fire brigade work. So policemen being policemen and firemen, this particular object was named after one profession, but the profession was known for two different jobs. The right GIF would help you better to lead to the answer if the left one is not clear. I believe I have a larger image. So I'm looking for one particular object. That was named after one profession that used to do two different jobs. Question 12. What four letter word is common to a curse for attracting bad luck? A children's game where two people unintentionally speak the same word or phrase simultaneously. And the original name of Jerry Mouse from Tom and Jerry. So three things, all common to one word, a four letter word. The first being a curse for attracting bad luck. The second being a children's game where two people unintentionally speak the same word or phrase simultaneously. And the third being the original name of Jerry Mouse. So Jerry was named something else earlier, and this is also a popular children's game. Also a word to associate curse for attracting bad luck. There are two alternative spellings, either of them will work. Looking for a four letter word. Question 13. After which real life personality is the airport in the game GTA Vice City quite aptly named? As the game is based on drug mafia and gangsters in the fictional version of Miami. So even if you have not played the game ever, look at the fact that it is a game based on drug mafia and gangsters, and it is based in Miami. So which real life personality gives the name to the airport in GTA Vice City, as popularly airports are named after personalities? So which real life personality gives the name to the airport in GTA Vice City? Question 14, the penultimate question, created by Pressman Toys. This particular card game has two-sided printed cards. I'll show you the image in a while. One side has questions such as bread or butter, spaghetti or meatballs, Loch Ness Monster or the Yeti. The other side is the answer, which the players have to guess. So what is the name of this card game? It is essentially a quiz-based card game, a question-answer-based card game. So there are cards printed on two sides. You can see Woody Woodpecker or Woody Allen, 7-11 or 7-up as some of the cards. I have other examples such as bread or butter, spaghetti or meatballs. So one of the most known ancient dilemma gives the name to this card game. I'm looking for the name of this card game. And the last question, which idiom originated in the 80s from the ADHD medicine, that is the attention deficit hyperactivity disorder medicine, for calming hyperactive people who were mostly children in those days. So in the 80s, majorly ADHD was suffered by children, and they were suggested to take the medicine, thus giving the idiom that I'm looking for. So what idiom is this that originated in the 80s when children were suggested to take the ADHD medicine? Children suffering from hyperactivity disorder were suggested to take ADHD medicine. Thus, what idiom originated? So I have the list of yesterday's winners, Abhinav Dhar and Anshul and Adarsh with 13 points, Gaurav Toyed and Gaurav and Toyed at 11, me scoring 9.5, and Vishad and Saurav at 9. So these are the winners of yesterday's quiz with the scores. I'll cycle back. Question number one was about the red telephone in a museum in Stockholm. Who are the four people that have the number? Only four people to have the number of this telephone. Question two was about an art form which has a tarpa in the center and shows village men with their hands entwined moving in a circle. Question three was about a location in London giving the name of these styled collars. Question four was about a business dominated by a particular community in United States. Question 5 was about the name of these alcohol glasses that have criminal photos printed on them. Question 6 was about JK Awards. JK Awards being named after whom? Question 7 was about DD No. So what regretful activity does it stop? Question 8 was about Ben and Jerry's and Netflix coming out with an ice cream, the flavor having a three-word title. The past tense of a phrase that is most commonly associated with Netflix, and the fact that this is an ice cream. Question 9 was about an unwanted occurrence which was thought as a result of chewing. Thus, the women in the court of Louis XI consuming only soup. So, what unwanted occurrence is this? Question 10 was about Brooklyn Nine-Nine and the sound that is used to switch between the past reference scenes and the present. The sound coming from an equipment that is commonly found with the policeman. Question 11 was about the nickname of progress bars that share their name with the nickname of the progress bars that get their name from a particular object that was associated with a profession that used to do two jobs. Question 12 was about a four-letter word common to three things. First being a curse attracting bad luck, second being a children's game where two people simultaneously speak the same word or phrase, and the third being the earlier name of Jerry the Mouse? Question 13 was about the airport in GTA Vice City. After whom is it named, a real life personality, given the fact that GTA Vice City is about drug mafia and gangsters set in the fictional version of Miami. Question 14 was about a card game created by Pressman Toys, which has questions such as bread or butter, spaghetti or meatballs, Loch Ness Monster or Yeti, Woody Woodpecker or Woody Allen, 7-Eleven or 7-Up. Looking for the title of the card game, which is one of the most known ancient dilemma. And the last question was about an idiom that came from the 80s when children suffering from hyperactivity disorder were suggested to take the ADHD medicine. Abhinav has requested for image of question 14. So this is the image. So I have blanked out guess something that is the title of the card game. And I see Nishant requesting for question one. I guess question one was about the telephone in the museum in Stockholm. So do send in your answers on Facebook, WhatsApp or Instagram. You can click a picture and send the answers or just type it down. And that is it. Do join tomorrow for another set of 15 questions, and we're accepting answers till 8:30. So it was fun doing this for the first time. Sorry for the delay again. There was some lag with the screen share issue. So I hope next time I do this, I do not consume more time with the setup. And I hope you like the quiz. The suggestions are welcomed on the home run page, or you can text me on either of the social media platforms. And that is it. Thank you. Goodbye.